Do you know how to motivate your prospect? How to open a sales call? How to prove a sales point? Would you like to have larger financial gain through higher production? Now, for the first time on record, Elmer Wheeler, the world's greatest salesman, takes you step by step through the secrets of successful selling. Whether you sell a product, service, or merely sell yourself to others, Elmer Wheeler's world-famous Wheeler Points will help you achieve your goal. Here to tell you about the five famous Wheeler Points and the revolutionary new sixth Wheeler Point is America's number one salesman, Mr. Elmer Wheeler.
What makes people buy? Have you ever made a sale in a hurry? And worst to gosh, you knew the exact words you used in that customer over there or that prospect, so you could use those same words and sell another one over here? What makes friends? Have you ever made a friend in a hurry? And worst to gosh, you knew the words you used on that friend over there, so you could repeat those same words and have another friend? What makes people buy anyway? Well, I think it's the sizzle that makes people buy. It's always been the sizzle. Even back in the days of Rome, it was a sizzle the first Roman merchant used back there to sell his fancy togas to his men customers. He'd hold up a fancy toga, and his only selling sentence was, "It'll make you look like a senator." Back in those days, they didn't mind looking like senators. I was in a Sears Roebuck store the other day, and while I was in there, a farmer came in to look at some long red underwear. Now, of all the selling appeals in long red underwear, that was a mighty smart trained sizzler. The only thing he said was, "They won't itch." And brother, if you've ever worn any long-handled underwear, that's all you want to hear too, isn't it? Let me tell you how I got in the business of selling the sizzle. It was a long time ago at Grandpa's farm. And every Sunday I used to put an apple box out in front of the farm. And I had a sign on it in 13 fancy colors that said, "Eggs, 20 cents. And I did a fair business. But one day the wind destroyed my sign. I built myself a crude homemade one. But being just a young fellow, I couldn't spell very well. So I had the S on backwards and the cent mark in the wrong spot. And that was the day my business doubled. Because all the city folks driving by on Sunday would look at my crude homemade sign and they say to themselves, "Ha, just a dumb country fellow, he won't have fancy city prices." So they used to pull up in front of my apple box. And just like a typical woman, she'd nudge her husband halfway out of the car and say, "Go on out and get me a dozen eggs." The poor fellow would come grunting out in front of the machine. And then she'd stick her head out the window and she'd holler, "Ask the boy, are they fresh?" Well, now I could have been ordinary. I could have told the lady, of course they're fresh, one day old eggs. But I knew that was a selling sizzle being used in the fancy city grocery stores for the past 20 years. So just to be a little bit different, whenever the women asked me, "Were they fresh?" I used to look them right smack in the eye and say, "Madam, do you mind waiting a moment till I get them fresh from the hen house?" Well, of course she didn't bother. So I went into the hen house, and here was my big sizzle. Just before I came out of the hen house, I kicked a little hen over, just enough to make her cackle. I always knew the hen would be there every Sunday, because every Saturday night I roped her into position. So just as I nudged the hen and she started to cackle, out I came holding the eggs in my right hand. Well, after hearing all that cackling going on behind me, did I have to tell those city folks how old those eggs were? Why, some of those poor women actually thought I went in, swept the hens off the nest, squeezed them, and had 1 second old eggs. Recently, I made a trip around the world. I wanted to study the art of bickering, bartering, beggaring, and bannering in all the bazaars, the flea markets, the thieves' markets. I wanted to talk to businessmen selling automobiles, selling real estate, selling insurance. I wanted to talk to retailers. I wanted to see how things were sold around the world, to see if I couldn't find some hidden, secret, or mysterious methods that made people buy in places like Tokyo, Turkey, in places like Cairo, in Rome, in London, in Paris, even in Tangiers. And when I came back after 90 days, I still found that our 5 points, plus our new 6-wheeler point, still apply to selling. So I'd like to give you now the 5 points, plus the 6th one, to help you get a job, a promotion, a sweetheart, or a sales order. to help you get more happiness in the home, more social success, or greater business gains. Because these points will do that for you. And it makes no difference who you are. In real estate, insurance, selling an intangible, selling a tangible. No matter what you are in life, these 5 points will help you become a better salesman and will help you build a surefire sales talk that sells. And here are the 5 points.